On this first Friday of Black History Month, the sound of the nation's capital, and no, not the usual beltway blabbering. We're talking about the nonstop beat of go-go, a style of music that is uniquely D.C. And although some may be trying to silence that sound, as our Faith Abube reports, you can try to slow it down, but nobody can stop go-go.
Washington, D.C., the nation's capital, home to the White House, Congress, countless museums, and the National Mall. But there is a rich culture outside politics that's less talked about beyond the metro area.
You can't talk about D.C. without talking about go-go.
Go-go, a free-flowing funk music genre, originated in D.C. in the early 1970s. For decades, go-go has been D.C.'s most influential homegrown cultural creation.
It is all live instruments, drums, congos, timbales, guitars, keyboards, horns, and everything. But the key to it is it's heavy on the percussion. It doesn't stop. Once the band starts, they don't stop until either the end of the show or until it's time to take a break and then come back for the next set. So that's why it's called go-go, because it just goes on and on and on.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got rare essence in the house tonight.
Andre Johnson, the guitarist for the legendary go-go band Rare Essence. He remembers when the heavy drum-based funk sound made its mark in the district.
When we started, it wasn't called go-go, and when we started, hip-hop wasn't even known yet. We were just playing DC music at that point, copying Chuck Brown.
One time for Chuck Brown, y'all.
The late Chuck Brown, known as the mastermind behind go-go music, also credited as the founder of the genre.
Do it by yourself, y'all.
He was the one that came up with the concept of, as soon as you finish the first song, you start right away with the next song.
I said special request, y'all. You got that go-go swing. Come on now.
Brown was known for his legendary live shows, a man whose reputation thrived on getting people to the dance floor and keeping them there for hours. His legacy lives on through the younger generation who took the baton and kept the music going. Brown's past paving the future for people like DJ Malcolm Xavier. He grew up listening to the music and now spins go-go records on the radio turntables.
It's the sound of the city, it's the sound of the DMV. You know, for us growing up here, it was not something that we could ever think that there was any other music other than go-go. Growing up, your first introduction to go-go is typically through your parents or your uncles, big brothers, big sisters, your aunts.
The legendary Backyard Band, one of DC's most recognized go-go bands to date, collaborating with some of the world's most famous artists. The band is most known for adding go-go flavor to the hottest songs on the Billboard charts.
When the audience hears the go-go version of the song, that makes them like the song, the original song, even more, because the go-go bands have adapted to it and they've made it, you know, a different song than what it is, but they still love it.
But for years, Johnson felt the groovy sounds of go-go were being silenced in its own birthplace, due in part to gentrification. Where go-go music venues once stood, condos and retail stores now occupy those spaces. And then the city ordinance crackdowns.
I want to say 2 years ago, there was a noise complaint filed for this Metro PCS store on Florida Avenue. Anytime you've driven past that store front, there's always go-go music playing.
The noise complaints igniting a new movement to keep the music going. Don't Mute DC, a movement that tried to save the music and shed light on the impact of gentrification.
They stopped us from playing, from all the clubs and the parks, everything.
Once that movement started, which was reactionary to, you know, gentrification, all those other things, it really made it kind of like, we need to make sure that people know that this is our sound and this is what our city feels like and stands behind, and it's part of our history, and you can't really erase that.
How have you guys evolved over the years to keep up with the time?
A lot of the old players, like, really abandoned go-go. You know what I mean? They were gone, went overseas and things of that nature. And, like, the young one, we kept it going. It just kept going out to generation after generation.
And though the music is still evolving, native lovers of the funky beats that keep going and going are certain their love for go-go will forever remain unchanged.
It means the world to me because this is all I've known.
And I think there's going to be a huge, huge, huge resurgence within the next 5 years.
And just keep having to show our future kids and our city and the lawmakers to put platforms together and different pieces together for our music won't die. But I ain't gonna let it die anyway, no matter what. I go to the steps of Capitol Hill, baby. 2020.
For ABC News Live, I'm Faith Abube in Washington.
You can't stop the go-go. Our thanks to Faith.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.